good, bro. Thank you.
Setting the throw on first down is Tua. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Second and 10. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. And this will complete to Will Fuller. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25. Midfield, here's Tua. Flushed out right. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
That was an interesting
because
as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Tua to throw again. He's letting this one go for Fuller. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off by Tavon Young. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
Xavien Howard up to make the tackle.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. To throw Huntley. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Justin Coleman. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about it. He shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job train.
There's four for a Dolphin touchdown.
Hey, if you can hear me after the kickoff, can you pause, please?
A first quarter lead. The point after it threw the raindrops up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game.
I was so worried about the stream and forgot to change my fucking shit.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard.
Hey, bro, can you pause real quick?
The The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
4-4, their record through 8 games on the season. Would you say that this team has overperformed, underperformed, or are they kind of right where you thought that they would be?
Do you mind if I say yes, yes, and yes? Because ultimately to me, 4-4 is about where they should be, because we've seen weeks where they've been really, really good. They've looked terrific. Other weeks where we wondered just how good is this team. They want to be consistent in their play, not consistently inconsistent, which is what they've been thus far.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
Jerome Baker, Dolphins leading tackler in 2020, in on the stop there. Huntley's throw into the hands of Andrews.
Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that, because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Chubb will have the first down and much more. And he's all the way down to the 6-yard line. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward.
Go! Hey!
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And they'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Bryce Love, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. Tucker with the extra point. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Can you pause, bro, please?
Down Miami as they get set to start the drive. They are currently mired in a losing streak. Now they get the short week for the Thursday night game. Do you see that as a potential positive, or is this just more in what has been really a string of bad luck for them?
Well, to me, it comes down to leadership, and leadership's got to spin it into a positive and make it an advantage for them. Yes, we're in a losing streak. Yes, no one thinks we can win, but we have the resources we need right here in this room. Let's go ahead and play better. Let's hang together and shock the world a little bit. Put it all together, they've got a chance of coming out with a W.
Now on 2nd and 13, Tua. He's letting this one go for Fuller. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And off the way in for a Miami touchdown. Will Fuller.
Bro, I know you hear me. Thank you. All right, I'm good. Thank you. I'm good, bro.
Sanders on for the extra point. Just about to say, had missed an extra point all season, but there it is, his first miss, no good. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They're riding a two-game winning streak in this Thursday nighter. How easy is it when you're on a roll to stay on a roll given the quick turnaround?
Well, you would think it'd be pretty easy because everyone's locked in practice and meetings because everyone feels good about themselves. And for coaches, this is where they have to tell themselves, don't add too much, don't worry about game plans as much as players. So look at your play sheet and think, give it to the guys who play best, and don't worry about the rest of it.
Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. The Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Here's Huntley. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. So, Charles, this defense, in for a tough matchup. What do you think the game plan is here tonight?
Well, I think the game plan is the same as most, which is, hey, pass rushers, do your job. Coverage guys, do your job. And the linebackers are going to be a mix. Sometimes they'll drop in coverage. Sometimes they'll pressure the quarterback. But all in all, you never want to let that quarterback get a string of completions going, because if so, they're hard to deal with, and it makes for a long evening.
Huntley to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Love. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
Well, I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield, everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield. And he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
They go play action here on first down. Rolling to his right. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down. Looking to throw. Huntley. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 24-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards. On first down, Huntley. He finds his man complete. It's Love. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. To throw. Huntley. Quick hitter here. It's complete. Touchdown! An 11-yard touchdown. And the Ravens can take the lead now if they hit the extra point.
The catch and the touchdown, they were the end result of a terrific route run by the receiver.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And with it, his guys take the lead here by a point.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's second down now. Throwing again on second and 10. Tua. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line.
Okay, partner, no surprise to you. I'm going to look at this from the defensive perspective. In the rain, you have to be more cautious trying to cover passing routes. Why? The offense knows where they're going with the football. The receiver knows the route he's going to run. You have to make sure you keep your footing underneath you.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. A give. This is Chubb. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
To throw on second down, Huntley. And that is incomplete. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
They had a great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a third and five. Looking to throw. Huntley, completion here to Claypool. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 yards to pick up there. Good for a Raven first.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to snap it right around the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Looking to throw on second down. Huntley. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there. And now they're looking at a first and goal.
Gonna give it to Love. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Well, the spotlight hit him once already tonight as he got into the end zone. He was trying to make it a double spotlight, wasn't he?
But credit the defense, bottling him up, not letting him get in. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Bryce Love with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year, as the Ravens push further out in front. John Harbaugh thought about it, and now his guys are going to go for the 2-point conversion. They'll look to throw, and this is going to be caught. It's good, and that extends their lead by 2 more. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive.
It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You've got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. An analytic.
Throw left side is complete on the diving effort.
What the fuck? That went right through my dude's hands.
29 officially. Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. Here's Fuller with a catch. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. It's another first down as they bite off 23 more on that one. First and 10 here. And, you know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost.
Oh, Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off at the 17. There he goes, left side. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
Now remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Yes, we are.
Set an aggressive tone, not just
number one defense. You heard that.
Put the balls in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
Here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. Grant, he will not return it, and his guys will begin at the 25. Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And with him down two scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. Tagovailoa trying again after the pick six. Going for the deep ball. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey.
Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Christian Wilkins. Just creating a disaster there for the offense as that one goes 16 yards in the wrong direction. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Ravens out in front as we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more because I thought
a 50-50 ball here and it's intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. Not the way you envision things to start out the third quarter. One play and already a turnover.
It's interesting. You and I were talking with the coach and he talked about how at halftime, as a play caller, he wanted to make sure he got a new script going for the second half, not just the one that he operated off of to start the game. Nowhere on that script did it have that result.
Try to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
I think we can all understand what they're thinking right now. They take over the ball in field goal range after the turnover, so they've got that in their hip pocket. But they've got to go for the end zone and turn this into a bigger point. Their thinking is a touchdown is really what they should get from starting here. Getting 3 points at the end of this drive, that would feel disappointing.
Tua's throw taken in by Long here.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Tua going to throw. He'll have a first down inside the 10. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. Give him 22 yards, and that's also where they snapped it from, the 22. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
An incomplete pass on first down. Here's second and goal. Tua sets up to pass it. Escaping the pressure right. There's Fuller for a Dolphin touchdown. Will Fuller there to make the grab. And the Dolphins use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. Tua going to try and throw for it. And the Dolphins are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. And that almost makes it a brand new ballgame. Now it's a one-score affair after they get the two.
And you have to know they were holding their breath on the two-point play because they had to have it to get it within the range that you just talked about. Dialed up their two-point play. It worked. Now they're feeling like they've got a shot at this one.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time, one play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one.
The throw here to Andrews, the tight end. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. That one good for 13 and a Raven first down. They give the Chubb out of the gun. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down. Back to throw, Huntley. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Coleman.
Good save, bro. Good save.
It's a pick six and a Dolphins.
Let's do this. We got a game.
Well, dare I say it, it's kind of quid pro quo. Both defenses now with an interception return for a touchdown.
Your vocabulary, sir. Well done.
So now on comes the Dolphins offense as they'll try and go for two here. After the turnover, it's Tua.
Oh, he's so lucky. I did not catch that shit.
They made a decision to go for two. They didn't get it. They remained down by 2 points. Should they have kicked it there?
Third quarter, I'm okay with it. Maybe first or second, you don't. I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah, I keep coming back to, I don't like to chase a lot of points.
Yeah.
But I also don't know what kicking an extra point being down one does for me.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they gave up the pick six. And now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 41 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. Now Chubb on first down, able to work his way forward for about five.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he will have a Ravens first down, at least at first glance, as he'll spot the football just beyond the marker. They find a way to convert on third and inches. Again, it's Ricard, the fullback. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. Chubb on the counter. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. To throw on third down. Huntley. Oh, no, he lost the football. And that ball popped free. We could hear it all the way up here. Those guys down on the field alerting everyone to the fumble. He's lucky that his offensive mates picked him up and jumped on him.
Yeah, and you have to think to yourself, and I'm sure they've been echoing it on the sideline and into the huddle. Guys, we have the lead. Just take care of the football. Don't make it easier for them.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Dolphins have got him.
Well, that takeaway, partner, right there, that's a combination of coaching, execution, and absolute belief. Because a lot of guys will look at the scoreboard and go, ah, this thing's pretty well done. But they still thought to themselves, if we could make a play, we give our teammates a chance to win it. And that's exactly what they did.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Following the fumble recovery, here's Tua. That is incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
To throw once more on second and 10. Tua. That's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. That's going to go down as a loss of five, and it brings up third down. Here's Tua. And the pressure gets there, and Tua is going to be taken down. T.J. Watt causing the disruption. He gets the sack. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Fuller. And he's not able to get away. He is stopped well, well short of a first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time. And that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of four. Well, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right. But the problem for them, is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And he is going to have the first down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd. 4 yards on the pickup, good enough to extend the drive.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Inside him up here to Ricard. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. A run for Nick Chubb. And he's taken down after a gain of three as they move it from the 22 to the 19. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On third down, here's Love. And he had to get this down to the 15. He won't make it. He's a yard or two short. It's a pickup of four, but they're still a yard short here with fourth down forthcoming. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And the Ravens are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there. And now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
They'll run with Chubb. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. It'll be a gain of five there as they move closer. It's second and goal.
Oh, Brandon, I'm going to tell you, this is football time to me. They're inside the 10-yard line. That's like drawing the line in the sand. Who's going to make the stand here? Defensive guys, they know if he gets in the end zone, this ball game is over. And the guys with the football right now, they're thinking, let's just pound it in there.
Got to hold them to three to keep this a one-score game. Give him right around four on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. Here's Love again. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
Everybody in the stadium knew what they were going to do right there, CD. Three tight ends on the field, all that extra bulk, and they run it in.
And you saw where that one went, right? You run it over your best blocker. I can just see the head coach right now. I want to run this one over the big boy. And they got it done.
Tucker with the extra point. And it might seal the deal as that makes it a two-score game here with not a lot of time remaining. Here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again, but they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly, then they'll take it from there.
And incomplete on the deep ball.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Here's Tua. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to let it fly. And he's just throwing the ball up for grabs now. Fortunately, that one going to fall incomplete. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
And that's into the hands of Gesicki. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Here's Michael Pilardi now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. This is fielded at the 7. A good return there, 17 yards. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before we hit triple zeros. Start out here with a jet sweep. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. So the final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory. And you've got to say, CD, it was the defense who had a big part in the W.
Not without question. When you force 4 turnovers, you get to enjoy the spoils of victory, don't you? It's rare that you force 4 turnovers and lose a ball game. That's almost unheard of. They carried this one home. He talked about celebrating with each other and being in a position where going forward, all you think about is, let's get 5 next time. They're going to be on the hunt.
So for the Ravens, the win gets them back over 500 at 5-4 on the year. And they'll get the weekend off now as they get a little extra time to prepare to face the Chicago Bears. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, they're going the wrong way as this will drop them to 3-7 now on the year. And they'll try and turn things around next week as they have a date at MetLife Stadium with the New York Jets. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Check, you was on for a minute. Rip me, put that. that, put that, I'll be back in a minute with my good boy.